Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of BT, the official sponsors, and on behalf of IEC, welcome to London, and welcome to the 21st Century Communications World Forum. I'm delighted to welcome you to, I think, what's going to be 4 days of very important discussion, reflection, and debate for everyone involved and affected by our industry, and that's a wide spectrum. As John said, I am BT's board sponsor for the 21st Century Network programme. I'm also a change, though, to the published programme that you've seen in the billboards out there. Matt Bross, BT's group CTO, should have been here this afternoon. Unfortunately, he's in the US attending to an important family matter, and he is sadly unable to join us this week. The communications industry finds itself at a defining moment today, at the start of the 21st century. Over the next 4 days, experts from many fields in our industry will talk about different aspects of the future, issues like change, like innovation, and challenge. All of these will, I'm sure, be recurring themes. And they're also themes I want to touch on in this address this afternoon. Whether you represent a fixed line or a mobile operator, a service provider, whether you work in one of the equipment manufacturers or a software vendor, or indeed whether you're a user of the services that we produce, there's an awful lot for us all to discuss over the next few days. And we're going to be talking about recent developments in new technology and the changing economics that underpin our industry. These have combined to create new opportunities and certainly new risks for us all. The rules of the game we all play in are changing. How we react to these new economic and technical realities will create the foundations for the industry in the decades to come. And it will help shape which of us succeeds and which of us fails. It really is, I think, that important. The 21st century brings the possibility of new business and new business models and the ability to create compelling new services for people to use. And I'm sure it's going to create winners and losers in the industry. Ultimately, the opportunity for the 21st Century Network is to bring about a step change in the way our industry creates and delivers services to customers, and to transform the role that we play, our industry plays, in the economies and the societies that we're all a part of. It's that big. It's that big. If we look back over the last 100 years or so to the beginning of the 20th century, I think things in this room would be quite different. The year would be 1905. The telephone would have been in existence for less than 30 years. And the audience would have come, I guess, from Europe, maybe perhaps from the US. There'd be nobody here at all from India, from the Far East. And getting here, if you came from abroad, would have been extraordinarily difficult. There would be little possibility, certainly, of keeping in touch with your office, whatever that is. That time was perhaps one of the halcyon days of our industry, experimental days of telecommunication, but it was a time, 1905, of great opportunity. And I think that's a common characteristic with where we are today. Telecommunications then was a fixed line, single service industry. It was the preserve of the privileged few. The old telegraph system would only recently have been replaced by telephone operators. And that was just the first of many waves of industry-changing innovation. Subsequently came electromechanical switching and later the arrival of electronics. By the 70s, we would witness the first steps, and I think the most important steps, towards what we are now in, the digital world. And those steps meant that nothing would be the same again. Today, we are certainly witnessing the birth of a fourth wave, the IP revolution. And like others before it, it's going to change everything that we do. Much has already changed. The traditional barriers of geography, of technology and difference have begun to fade away in the industry. The landscape I work in, you work in, is different, a lot, decisively different from what it was even 10 years ago. The distinction between fixed and mobile worlds has blurred. And perhaps more importantly, the division between IT, between information technology and the network, is rapidly eroding. Today, we all live, work, and play in what we call the digital networked economy. True convergence, long talked about, is gaining rapid momentum. It's with us today, and that will increase, be an increasing feature of our world in the 21st century. I think it's a very exciting and interesting time to be in the communications industry. The fourth wave became inevitable the day we learned how to fully digitise our industry. Digitised voice, data and video, of course, can now be combined, changed, merged, manipulated on a single digital platform. And if that ability to merge multiple information formats on a single platform is driving the pace of convergence at the device level, the need for carrier class multi-service IP networks and software-driven switching are fueling the agenda of fundamental change in the communications industry and among communications operators. Everybody, we all are looking for better productivity, for greater efficiency, and technical innovation tries to meet that demand. It always has done. Often it succeeds, it helps us. Sometimes it misses the target. Sometimes technical innovation creates a different and unexpected demand. Think about, for example, the growth of SMS, of text messaging, or ringtone downloads, big revenue and profit generators for the mobile industries today, but not central elements of the strategic business plans when they were conceived. Came from nowhere. In the industry I sit in, the transmission of voice calls over IP is for sure a reality today, and I've no doubt whatever it will replace narrowband switch traffic as the preferred medium of communications. That's why we're here. Make no mistake, that move to voice over IP poses a very real threat to established telcos like BT, like many of you in this room. But it also offers, I think, some fantastic new possibilities. For any of us, for any incumbent operator, the future strategic direction is the key issue, and we all have positives and negatives as we address our future strategies. Embracing the IP future requires huge scale investment and certainly the adoption and a large scale of new skills in our businesses. For me, having begun to work through it, it poses gargantuan operational challenges and is going to require new skills, new behaviours in depth in my company. The size of the financial, technical and operational challenge in moving to all IP is simply enormous. But in many ways, as is always the case in times of great change, the human challenge of what we face is, I believe, even greater than those technical and logistical challenges. My business and BT, we already have the size, the scale, we already have the experience to manage major multi-billion pound asset deployments. We have the investment, the cash flows and the investment strength to upgrade our networks, to migrate customers to new platforms and to exploit new opportunities. But we also, let's face it, we have our downsides. Our legacy, our history, which is not in the IP world, can slow us down. Our size could be a barrier to speed. You know, for me, thinking about the challenge of bringing 100,000 employees, millions of customers, a multitude of strategic partners, investors, the government, the regulator, policymakers, bringing them all with us in this transition to IP is a huge body of work, a great human challenge that I want to talk a little bit more about later. But at the heart of it, I think, is that the economics of our industry are changing, or at least the economic pressures we face are intensifying. Let me give you a couple of examples. In 1993, AT&T carried over 7 billion minutes of international traffic and billed over a dollar a minute for each. By 2003, AT&T was carrying almost twice as many minutes 14 billion minutes and was charging just 30 cents each. In just 10 years, international traffic into and outside of the US quadrupled in total, given the other carriers. But the scary bit, total revenues for that international industry, IDD industry, fell from $11 billion to $8 billion. That represents, in real terms, an 80% reduction in revenue per minute over really quite a short period of time, just 10 years. We all face those challenges, I guess, but the numbers are simply huge. In my business, BT Wholesale, market pressure, regulatory pressure means that I drive price cuts of something like £250 million every year. £250 million of value erosion every year. Other parts of BT, other operators in the UK, everybody around the world is witnessing, I think, similar margin and revenue pressure, margin and revenue reductions. Massive cost reductions or absolutely huge new revenue growth have to be achieved just to stand still in profitability terms. In my case, it's something like £1.5 billion of new wave revenues every year just to stand still in profitability terms. That's hard work. You know, our industry is tough. It's as tough as any in the world. So if you're an equipment vendor in the audience, guess why we in BT and the rest of us continually push for reduced equipment costs. We all have to share in the economic pressures that we face in the industry. It's a fact. Telecommunications is incredibly tough, and it's getting tougher every year. In the last couple of weeks alone, AT&T and MCI, formerly WorldCom, the two giants of the industry, have essentially gone away, consumed by SBC and Verizon, respectively. And you know, if you think about value again here, it's interesting. In 1996, when WorldCom acquired MFS, a relative minnow in the industry, serving mainly, I guess, New York and parts of New Jersey, WorldCom paid $14 billion for MFS. And that's just a little less than what SBC are paying for AT&T today. That is just incredible. MCI was left of the WorldCom conglomerate, if you like, has been sold for just over $5 billion, a third of what it itself paid for MFS. The erosion of value in our industry is simply astounding and affects everybody in this room. Size, scale, continuity, for those of us who come from big companies, it is absolutely no guarantee of success as we go forward into the 21st century. In fact, what brought success in the past could so easily bring us our downfall in the future. It's getting tough, and it's getting tougher every year. That's why we're here. So what do you do? What do we do in this harsh and uncertain economic climate? Some players around the world, faced with the uncertainty, have decided to hunker down, to strip back investment, to manage our businesses for cash. And certainly, telecommunications businesses are usually big cash generators. It's a real option. Just hunker down and wait and see what happens when the risk profile reduces. We thought about that at BT. It's a valid strategy, but we felt one ultimately doomed. At BT, we believe absolutely at this time of uncertainty, there is a real need to be aggressive and to be radical in the way we go forward. We see real growth opportunities in new wave businesses, especially in ICT, the bringing together of communications and IT, in mobility, and in broadband. All three offer fantastic growth opportunities, but we have to commit. We have to invest. We need to be radical to capitalize fully in the opportunities in those areas. We've decided to do that. The underpinning strategy that enables it to happen, to go for growth in BT, is 21CN, our 21st century network strategy. And we're really going for that. 21CN is a multi-service IP network end-to-end with an integrated system stack to support it. It's comprehensive, it's a single network for multiple services instead of multiple networks for multiple services. It radically simplifies, it radically reduces costs, and it radically speeds up our ability to deploy new products and services. In fact, we're deploying common capabilities like billing, like automation, common product capabilities across our service set so that we can speed up product development and product introduction. I don't know about in your companies if you're an operator, but in BT, no matter how hard we push it, with the complexity and scale of our networks today, it takes us something like 18 months to bring a completely new product from conception to the market. That's far, far too slow. We aim to reduce the lead time of new product introduction to less than 6 months with 21CN. And we have to do it. I mean, think about the beat rate of innovation that we all face in our industry. For the first 80 years, our business, our industry was a single product, single service, the telephone. It's only 20 years ago that mobile telephony became a reality. 10 years ago, I sat at conferences here and the internet was hardly a reality, only 10 years ago. And it's less than 5 years for most of us that broadband became the thing. The beat rate of change is speeding up for us all, and we have to speed up as businesses to match the customer demand and the customer requirements that come on the back of that. The life cycle for new technology is reducing all the time, and in this environment, reducing time to market is absolutely critical. 21st Century Network will help BT achieve this. 21CN has been built for a converged world where customers' experiences are simple and complete, where we make it easy for them to converge services, where customers have direct control over the way they choose and use and change, and the direct control of the way they change the services that they use, when they want to, wherever they want to. These are services that will continue to improve a customer's quality of life, services that will make their professional and personal lives easier and more productive. Simplicity, though, I think, is the key. And we, as an industry, haven't traditionally always made it very simple. 21CN is a broadband and multimedia world where the customer can access any communication service from any device, anywhere, at home, in the office, out in the road, all with increasing broadband speed. It will offer a rich array of information and entertainment services to whatever device the customer chooses. Handsets, for example, will talk to the fixed network if you're in the hotel or in the office or at home, but will communicate with the mobile network when you're out and about or out in the road or in a train. Services like televisual information and entertainment will be delivered to your PC or handheld device. More choice is the theme, more flexibility, and greater freedom for customers to choose services both at work and at play. I think for all of us, delivering this ability to personalize, delivering customers the ability to personalize, to choose to swap services between the spoken, between email, between voice, is key. The ability to communicate without boundaries, a world where everybody has access to modern communications. That's the vision. BT's 21st century network transformation will accelerate and enable the arrival of this new world, and you're going to hear an awful lot more about it from BT speakers over the next few days. It is, I believe, the most complete, the most exciting, and I think the most ambitious business transformation program underway anywhere in the telecommunications industry today. And if it's fun and exciting, it's also a bit scary. 21CN is a next generation network infrastructure, but it's much more than that. We believe 21CN is the enabling infrastructure for growth in BT, for our industry, and I don't think it's too strong to say it, for our society, the society in which we operate here in the UK in particular. It's really ambitious. It means, 21CN means, for example, that BT will be the first incumbent operator in the world to switch off the PSTN. We're going to switch off the phone service. By the end of this decade, the vast majority of our customers will be in all IP. It's actually happening today. Just take a look at this short video about our start.
Yesterday, we did have fiber calls. So for the first time, we actually have live customers going across the Plain-Montana network. This is BT Arkansas making the future come alive today.
This is really exciting for me because it's really happening now.
We've now got analog towers on the board online. Hello?
Hello.
Oh, wonderful. I can now load up my software, yeah? But these pages are clean. It's very good.
So the road to 21CN has been a challenging one. In October, we launched the voice over IP trials.
Okay, well, I think now starts the 21C transformation.
That's the infrastructure that will become the foundation of our future network.
This might be one small step forward.
Data,
and one big step for beta.
You guys have done a fabulous job, and it's working.
Yeah. No problems at all.
Really?
Only the alarm clock that's
This is the real thing, okay? This is actually live customers, live traffic, and the most important thing is it's our operations people on the ground understanding what the future is all about. And more importantly, learning the lessons today that will help us define tomorrow.
This will be the future. Let's hope so. Business as usual now with live calls.
Oh, I can tell you what I'm doing next week. I'm going on holiday.
I love that. It's real BT people, a real network, and it's right now. For me, for them, hopefully for us all in the room, 21CN is exciting, it's radical, it's now, and it's very, very real. And why are we doing it? I guess 10 years ago, IT and communications were discrete worlds, but IP and the internet, as I've said, changed everything. Today, it really is very difficult to differentiate between the two. Think about broadband connections, voice over DSL, voice over IP accessed over a PC connection. The world has become irreversibly network-centric. All electronic equipment today has the potential to be a network device, as we know, from your television to your hi-fi to your camcorder or even your fridge. You know, we've talked about that for a while. It's becoming a reality. We're seeing the beginnings of the wired home revolution, or more likely, I think, the wireless IP home revolution. The network will sit at the heart of the home and society. It will be the nervous system that fuels the economy, fuels government, business, and human relationships in a way like never before. There will be a massive explosion. It's happening right now, we know it, of ambient intelligence over the next 10 years. Processor costs, we know, are plummeting. We're now talking about internet routers on a chip. Innovation and new service development in that environment really will only be curtailed by human imagination. So all of this is a vision for the market to exploit, and the real question is, who's going to win as we exploit new opportunities? I think the answer is whoever can create smart applications that the market wants and is willing to pay for. So why smart applications? Why is this so important for a telecommunications company? At the most fundamental level, for me, for BT, it's about staying in business, and not all the big guys do. An ICT-orientated network company like BT will be well-placed to succeed where others perhaps may not. Not yet anyway. That's why we're going for it. Convergence of technologies leads to convergence of industries. Traditional IT companies are well positioned to succeed in this world. And if BT, if telcos like BT sit back and watch, we could be relegated to commodity players at best. All the value could be created beyond the network. But 21CN is designed to embed the potential of the future in the network, not on the network. But of course, being an IP platform based on open standards, 21CN will offer others the opportunity to compete too, not just BT. Other operators will be able to access the functionality and intelligence that we're creating in BT's 21CN network. It will enable anyone to build applications. It won't just restrict creativity to traditional players. And therefore, in the IT-centric IP communications world, it will be cheap, much cheaper than it was in the past, to experiment. We aim to let that happen, and I believe very many will. And that's different from how we, the communications industry, typically create services today. For most of us, we kind of work in a one-size-fits-all, take-it-or-leave-it high-volume business. Niche applications generally aren't profitable for us, the way we've built service. Unless you're a large corporate customer, maybe with a big enough IT department to customize the services on the network to match your requirements, unless you're one of those, you kind of get what we give. And in saying that, I'm not putting our industry down. We've achieved some fantastic things in the last century, but what was good enough in the past won't be good enough in the future. 21CN is designed to offer the ability to customize any aspect of any service at any level. And clearly, delivering that capability is hugely down to the systems architecture. I would say to you, if you get a chance, go and listen to Al Noor Ramji, chief executive of BT's One IT operation, and his team, who will talk in more detail here at the forum about how he and the team are building systems to make this happen. Go along and listen if you can. But like I said, in the IP world, it's going to be cheap to experiment, and many will. New organizations, new people, new business models, that's what we're creating. I think that opening up the ability to create applications to others will help bring about the growth, the killer applications, if you like, the elusive thing that we all desire in the industry. And I believe many, like the SMS example I shared with you earlier, will come from pretty unexpected places. That's good. But all will need the power of the network to function and to deliver the experience. And that's my job, our job, to create the power in the network to experiment. So what's in it for customers? For large corporate customers, for example, large corporates are looking to communications to help expand their customer base, to improve top and bottom line revenue growth and to reduce costs. They need smart network applications to deliver. They want to deploy integrated network IT solutions all the way across their supply chains. But they want to also be able to customize, to do it in a unique way. They will want to tailor network services easily, quickly, and cheaply. I'm sure many are telling me they want to be relieved of the burden of creating all this customization themselves, which is what has been going on. Many will want to forget about how you do it in the network and focus on servicing their customers. And what about smaller businesses? Think about competition in the business world. It's easier and cheaper. It's going to be easier and cheaper to enter new markets with ubiquitous IP across the world than it ever was before. Small and medium enterprises are going to have the ability on this network to act like corporate businesses with scale. They will be able to project a global business presence and compete with the bigger guys. I mean, historically, SMEs have been unable to enjoy the same level of customization of network services that their bigger competitors have been able to afford. But all of this has already begun to change. I mean, take IP-centric services. They already give smaller enterprise the ability to integrate voice and email on the move, in a hotel, in an office, actually in a way that many bigger corporations with their legacy find it difficult to emulate. That's what IP can bring. So the ability to customize, to personalize, and to change service parameters in real time is going to be available to all customer groups. And that, I think, is going to create a new playing field where size won't guarantee long-term success. When was the last time any of us visited a travel agent to book a flight or a hotel room? Think about the music industry. Napster changed everything. And in the 1990s, it's estimated that Napster and its peers increased the consumption of bandwidth worldwide by threefold. Came from nowhere. The music industry resisted that digital change for a few years, but now it's finally conceding and considering new business models, new ways to make money in the 21st century. Think about music downloads and devices like the Apple iPod. These new disruptive technologies have the power to revolutionize entire industries, actually in months, literally, not years. The iPod's already sold, I think, 10 million devices in the short time since it launched, and many of its users using iTunes and music downloads, changing the way we operate and buy in a major industry. So faced with the threat of radical change in behavior and habits, businesses, both large and small, will look to harness the power of the network as a key to competitive advantage. And, you know, you might think that sounds a bit like a speech from the peak of the dot-com bubble. But the truth is that many of the ideas dreamt up during the bubble are starting to become real. Just because people confuse the internet's ability for instantaneous communication with the, confused it with the ability or the attempt to make money overnight, doesn't make those ideas bad ideas. For consumers, I believe the 21st century promises a real revolution in choice and control over the way they buy and use communication services from us. And that's exciting. It's radical for us as operators. It's 21st century stuff. The irony, though, is that making things simple in our industry and for consumers is actually an extremely complicated task and a major challenge for us all. Initiatives like 21CN challenge large parts of our industry. It's a part of that human challenge I talked about earlier. BT is uniquely taking a fully transparent, inclusive approach to the revolution in the UK. We've consulted extremely widely with operators around the world, with vendors, with customers and policymakers, and we continue to do so transparently, participatively. And our support, I guess, of this event is part of that program. If you think about why are we doing that, if you think about my customers, BT Wholesale's customers, John said earlier, 500 mobile operators, fixed operators, service providers in the UK, every ISP, every operator in the UK interconnects with BT's network. And it's all moving to IP. Because we say so? No, because we all have to want it to happen. We all have to participate in making it happen. To ensure that every organization, all of these organizations, these customers, have a voice and a forum to understand their plans in detail and to contribute to those plans, because it's not just about BT. We've created something called Consult 21. I believe it's the largest voluntary industry consultation program of its kind anywhere. Consult 21 supports a range of working groups to produce detailed plans for interconnection, for technical standards, for timing, and the commercial arrangements as we move towards an all IP world. It helps make 21CN a reality for a whole industry and not just for BT. It's a real important element in addressing that human challenge that we face. Vendors, many vendors in the room today, also have a big, important role to play in helping with the human challenge. Our industry has been characterized for too long by national operators like BT working with traditional national equipment vendors. Systems in this world were proprietary. One equipment vendor's kit wouldn't work with another's, and so on. No more. We cannot afford to let that continue. It's time to change it. For many years, our IT colleagues in the enterprise world have had the benefit of open systems, of plug-and-play compatibility and components. And 21CN will push the communications equipment in this direction too. There has been intense competition in the vendor community to participate to work with BT on 21C, and I guess that's because first mover experience is seen as valuable. But for BT, our requirement has been to insist on vendor independent interworking and open standards. And the industry has come with us. It's worth pushing for. They've also given us access to source code. That's radical human change, radical industry and behavioural change to make it work. I absolutely believe if we get it right, our industry can move with confidence to a truly open future, breaking with the closed traditions of the past. We are at an advanced stage in BT of selecting our vendor partners for 21CN after an intense and accelerated ITT process. And there's going to be more news about this in the coming weeks. It's a great example of how we can win the human challenge if we focus on bringing people together openly, take an open and inclusive approach to the change that we're trying to drive. And that's a key message for everybody here. Openness and transparency, which haven't characterised our industry, I'm sure are critical for success in the 21st century. So, to conclude, we are facing the fourth wave of innovation in our industry, and it will require change on a massive scale. There are real opportunities for us all, and there are threats. However, we at BT believe that the risk of doing nothing, of standing still, as a technical and economic sands shift beneath our feet, is a much bigger threat than going for it. We are going for it, and we're moving BT from an incumbent telephone company to a networked IT services and solutions company fit for the 21st century. 21CN will move BT decisively from narrowband to broadband. It will move us decisively from a product focus to a customer focus. And it will move us decisively from selling capacity to selling capabilities for our customers. It is a gargantuan technical, logistical, and operational test, but I believe we do in BT, with our industry partners, we have the ability and the capability to deliver. Convergence is driving the need for change and will bring a wealth of new services and a radically better experience for those people and businesses that use our communication services. And this is not just about BT, but it's not actually just about the telecommunications industry. It's also about how we support our economies and our society. It's about helping create a better society. It's about helping create better lives for people and for businesses. Take 21CN. We'll invest something like £10 billion in this programme. It's fundamental to the UK economy. 21CN will help our customers to compete at home, but will help our customers, our businesses, compete abroad and in overseas markets. It will help those in the UK tasked with attracting and retaining inward investment to help make the UK a compelling business location of choice in the global marketplace. For society, what we in the communications industry do really matters. What we do really matters for everyone. The future will allow us in the industry to do more, to support people, to help people more, and to help them learn more. It's not about call minutes anymore. The change is already with us. There's no going back. And for us in BT, the toothpaste is already well out of the tube. In communications, you innovate and invest or die. And we've chosen to invest. Enjoy the event, and thank you very much for your attention.